Welcome to the ACMG Knowledge Nugget on newborn screening for very long-chain acyl-CoA dehydrogenase, or VLCAD deficiency. This activity is intended for educational purposes only. Neither I nor the Planning Committee have any disclosures. This session is approved for 0.25 CME. To obtain CMEs for this activity, you will need to pass the quiz with a score of at least 80% and complete the evaluation. This session is a companion to the Very Long-Chain Acyl-CoA Dehydrogenase, or VLCAD Deficiency, ACT Sheet, which is freely available at www.acmg.net/ACT. ACT Sheets are intended to be immediate resources for providers who encounter positive newborn screening results. Please keep in mind that a newborn screening result is just the first step in the diagnostic process. Further testing and evaluations are needed to determine if the newborn has the disease, a true positive result, or is unaffected, a false positive result. The ACT sheets are intended to provide an overview of the diseases identified by newborn screening and clear next steps for the management of a positive newborn screening result. This session will cover background information on VLCAD deficiency, including clinical features and the underlying genetic cause, actions a primary care provider needs to take upon receiving a screen positive test result for VLCAD deficiency, clinical considerations, and supplemental resources. Very long-chain acyl-CoA dehydrogenase deficiency, or VLCAD deficiency, is a genetic condition caused by pathogenic variants found in the ACADVL gene. This gene provides instructions for the creation of an enzyme called very long-chain dehydrogenase. This enzyme is responsible for breaking down a certain type of fat, called long-chain acylcarnitines, specifically the C14-1 acylcarnitine. The metabolism of these fats helps to make energy for the heart, liver, and muscles. This gene variant leads to a decreased amount of very long-chain dehydrogenase enzymes, which then results in decreased fat metabolism. The decreased fat metabolism causes a decrease in energy production, particularly during episodes of prolonged fasting or increased energy demands, such as those that occur during fever, illness, or stress. There are three types of VLCAD deficiency that are categorized based on the onset of symptoms: early onset VLCAD deficiency, childhood onset VLCAD deficiency, and adult onset VLCAD deficiency. Early onset VLCAD deficiency is the most severe and begins in infancy. Symptoms include lethargy, muscle weakness, low blood sugar or hypoglycemia, liver problems, and heart problems, such as cardiomyopathy or arrhythmias. Childhood onset VLCAD deficiency begins during childhood and includes an enlarged liver or hepatomegaly, muscle weakness, and low blood sugar. Adult onset VLCAD deficiency begins in adolescence or adulthood. The symptoms associated with adult onset VLCAD deficiency involve muscle pain and muscle tissue breakdown called rhabdomyolysis. This muscle tissue breakdown can cause urine to be red or brown as a result of the myoglobin protein that is released from the kidneys. Symptoms of VLCAD deficiency can be triggered by fasting, exercise, illness, or exposure to hot and cold temperatures. Management of VLCAD deficiency includes regular and frequent meals and avoidance of fasting, medium-chain triglyceride supplementation, and IV glucose administration if severely ill. VLCAD deficiency is inherited in an autosomal recessive manner, meaning that only infants with a pathogenic variant in both of their ACAD-VL genes will be affected. Parents with a child with VLCAD deficiency are carriers and are unaffected, but have a 25% recurrence risk with any future children they have together. All states in the United States provide newborn screening for VLCAD deficiency. A good resource for checking a state's newborn screening panel is the newbornscreening.hrsa.gov website. Screening for VLCAD deficiency is performed by examining levels of plasma acyl-carnitines, which are typically elevated in this condition. Now that you have an understanding of what VLCAD deficiency is, let's talk about what to do if you have a patient screen positive for VLCAD deficiency during newborn screening. You will need to take the following actions. First, contact the family and do the following. Inform them of the newborn screening result and that more testing is needed to determine if their child does or does not have VLCAD deficiency. Ascertain clinical status, paying close attention to signs like poor feeding, lethargy, and vomiting. Provide the family with basic information about VLCAD deficiency, including the need to avoid fasting, especially for newborns. Second, take a family history. Because VLCAD deficiency is inherited in an autosomal recessive manner, it is common for there to be no known family history of VLCAD deficiency. Third, arrange an immediate and same-day referral to a pediatric metabolic specialist for a comprehensive clinical evaluation, discussion of a treatment plan, and genetic counseling. Fourth, working with the appropriate specialist, take steps to ensure biochemical and/or molecular confirmation of the newborn screening result. Confirmatory testing includes molecular genetic testing and/or functional studies, such as enzyme testing. If clinically indicated, an echocardiogram may also be considered. Fifth, report the final diagnostic outcome back to your state newborn screening program. As you continue to care for your patient with a positive newborn screen result for VLCAD deficiency, it is likely additional questions and concerns will come up. Here are some resources where you can obtain information on VLCAD deficiency, appropriate laboratories and tests, and genetic specialists. Before we end today's session, let's have a quick review. First, VLCAD deficiency is a serious condition, and identification of affected individuals is essential for the administration of early treatment. Second, newborn screening may identify VLCAD deficiency prior to symptom onset. This allows for earlier management and can help prevent symptoms and complications. Third, ACT sheets are freely available on the ACMG website to review in the event of a screen positive result. In addition to VLCAD deficiency, ACT sheets are available for many other conditions that can be identified through newborn screening.